Hi everyone, welcome back. Having discussed in my previous videos about how to add different angular chart types of Syncfusion like line chart, financial charts, circular charts, triangular charts, polar and radar charts to an angular application. Now, in this video, I will explain about how to customize the chart axis with categorized values to display the text values on horizontal axis instead of numeric intervals, along with its customizable options. In this case, I may need to make use of the category axis in my chart to achieve this. So, before looking onto it, let me show you a simple example. Here, if you look at this column series chart, it shows the gold medals won by different countries. So, here the text values are displayed, that is, the country names are displayed at the x-axis by making use of the category axis. Also, the x-axis is further enhanced with other customizable elements like axis labels and axis range. So, now let me show you how to write code to achieve these scenarios using my existing application. As I have already explained about how to add a simple angular chart of Syncfusion to the application, please listen to my Getting Started video to know the basic steps. And you can find its reference link in the description part below. First, let me open my existing application and I will start adding the column series chart to it. So, I will open the app module file and import the column series service and the category service from Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Charts package and inject the same within the provider section as well. So, within the app component HTML file, I have simply retained the necessary properties of the chart like primary x-axis, primary y-axis, title, data source, xname and yname. And now, I will show you how to introduce a few changes to this chart code to customize the x-axis with the categorized data. In case, if you want to know how to define these properties to your angular chart, you can refer my Getting Started video again, where I have shown the step-by-step procedures on how to define them. So, now let me show you what kind of data I am going to pass to the chart's data source, as I have planned to display the chart showing the gold medals won by different countries. So, let me open the app component class, and here I have defined the Olympic Games data with the country names assigned to the x-axis and the relevant gold medal count to the y-axis. And now I have assigned this data object to the data source property of the chart and then map the data source field name and value to the appropriate chart properties like xname and yname. The next thing is, I have changed the chart title as Olympic medals to convey what chart data is illustrating. Now, I will set its series type as column. And to create a stunning visual effect, let me set the color for the chart series using fill property, which accepts either hexa or RGBA color code. Now, the basic settings to display a column series chart is done, and the important step here is I need to define the category axis now to display the x-axis with country names instead of default numeric values. So, to do that, I need to set the x-axis value type as category now. Within the app component class, let me define the value type property and set its value as category within the x-axis object. As I have already mapped this x-axis object to the primary x-axis property of the chart. So here, you can view the column series chart with the categorized x-axis displaying the appropriate text labels such as USA, China, and so on. And the main title is changed to Olympic medals. Now, let me set the relevant title for x-axis and y-axis of the chart. So, I will open the app component class and set the appropriate title for x-axis as countries within the x-axis object. And for y-axis, I will set its title as medals, as these variables are already mapped with the appropriate properties of chart like primary x-axis and primary y-axis. Therefore, you can view the chart output now with the relevant x-axis title as countries and y-axis title as medals. Well, now I will explain the category axis properties one by one with simple scenarios. In the start output, you can see here that the data items are shown based on the index value of the data source. Say for example, the index value of 0 represents USA in the data source, 1 represents China, and so on. Now, let me show you how to display the data items starting from China to Germany on the chart. To do this, I may need to set the custom range on the x-axis. So, to set the custom range on x-axis, I will add two additional properties now within the x-axis object, which is minimum and the maximum. For these options, I may need to set the index value of the data points from the data source. So, here I am going to set the minimum value as 1 and the maximum value as 5. These values allows me to display the data source items whose index ranges between 1 and 5. As I have already mapped this x-axis object to the primary x-axis property of the chart, now let's view the chart output directly. So here, you can view the chart output that displays the data items starting from China to Germany. You can check the index value of these data items from its data source, where China lies at the index 1 and Germany lies at the index 5. Like the minimum and maximum options, if I want to set the custom interval on x-axis, I may need to make use of the interval property. Here, the default interval is usually set to 1 so that the chart displays all the data items from China to Germany. Well, the next important property is the label placement, with which you can place the labels either between the ticks or exactly on the ticks. By default, the labels in the chart axis will be placed between the ticks as shown. So, now I will show you how to place the axis labels exactly on the ticks by setting the label placement property with its value as onTicks within the x-axis object. And now, you can view the chart output that displays the axis label that are positioned exactly on the ticks. In the start output, have a look at this axis label at the edge, where the label Germany seems to be cropped and placed outside the chart area. So, now I will show you how to move this axis label at the edge inside the chart area by setting the edge label placement property to shift within the x-axis object. And now you can view the chart output that displays the axis label Germany within the chart area. Alright, finally I will show you how to display the data points on chart based on the indexed or actual x-axis values. To understand the usage of this particular functionality, let me change the series type to line and import the line series service from Synfusion EJ2 Angular Charts package and inject the same within the provider section as well. And to make this scenario more clear, I'm going to remove these properties from x-axis object. Now, I will set the isIndexed property of x-axis to true so that the chart values are plotted based on the index of the data points from the data source. Say for example, if you have the data source with some repeated x values like China on two data points but with different y values. Now, when you look onto the chart output, you can see that the chart will plot these data points individually at the desired index by rendering the same x values twice on the axis. In case, if I want to truncate such duplicate x-axis values and display the data points based on the actual data instead of such index rendering, I can set isIndexed property to false so that the x-axis displays the repeated value only once and plot the data points accordingly on the graph. Here, you can view the chart output with a disabled indexed category axis that shows the data items based on the actual data value. Finally, let me summarize some of the important points which we have discussed in this session. We have seen how to categorize the x-axis of the angular charts by customizing its value type, positioning the ticks labels either on the ticks or between the ticks. And finally, we have also seen how to enable or disable the isIndexed property while using the category axis. So, in my upcoming videos, I will show you how to customize the other axis types of Synfusion Angular charts. And if you find this video as useful, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel as well. Thank you once again for watching this video.